Hey, what's up? Welcome to this Final Cut Pro tutorial. Today, we're going to be talking about blend modes. Blend modes are essentially algorithms to specify how two layers blend with each other. They can be extremely useful in your workflow for tasks like compositing or advanced color grading. Using blend modes in Final Cut Pro is pretty straightforward, and I'm going to show you how to use them. So with this first shot, I want to add a snow overlay, which I have right here in the browser. Let's drag it into the timeline. The snow was shot on a black background, so to isolate it, we're going to set the blend mode to screen. Screen removes the dark pixels and blends the remaining light pixels with the base layer below. To change the blend mode, we're going to select our snow layer and navigate to the inspector panel. If we scroll down to the bottom, we'll see the blend mode option under compositing. Click the drop-down menu and select screen. Instantly, the black is gone and the snow is isolated. Now, what's cool is that Final Cut actually renders the shot automatically in the background. We'll go ahead and add a quick grade to the shot, and we're done. We have another shot here, and I want to add a grain overlay just to give it that cinematic film look. Now, notice the grain isn't white pixels on a black background. It's actually lighter and darker grain on a neutral 50% gray background. This time, we're going to select overlay. Overlay will make the neutral gray portion transparent while blending both the lighter and darker grain details with the base layer. You can change the intensity by using the opacity slider. Let's add a bleach bypass preset from the effects browser and finalize the shot. This last shot is a trailer title, and I think it would be awesome to add some grungy elements over it. I'm going to drag a few pre-rendered glitch elements into the timeline, and this time we're going to combine multiple blend modes. For this shot, we want to isolate the light colors, so we'll use screen. For these scratches, we actually want to preserve the black details and eliminate the white background, so we'll use multiply, which is basically the inverse of screen. We'll add a couple more elements using screen, and lastly, we'll add a grain layer on top, set it to overlay to eliminate the neutral gray background, and there we go. By simply combining several elements and using various blend modes, we've definitely taken this title to the next level. So that's a quick overview on blend modes. There are many different blend modes that go beyond what we've covered today, and you may find some really cool uses for them. All the assets used in this tutorial are available for download, so you can recreate the composites shown or create your own. So, thank you so much for watching, and good luck with your edits.